gifted and ever-loving degree. Healer solar logo in his system of love, and the planetary logo within a team, the dragon of wisdom love. This force, when rightly directed and properly controlled, is the great transmuting agency, which eventually will make the human unit a master of religion, a lord of love, a dragon of wisdom and lesser degree. Finally, in a system, the objective physical manifestation of the logo is interpenetrated by his astral body as a species of human manifestation. As the logo is polarized in his cosmic astral shape and has not yet attained cosmic mental manifestation, the force of desire nature is the main incentive for the subjective life and lives that underlie the form. If the student ponders and share these five facts, he will get a clue to the problems that exist and realize around us. The causes of the heat of the solar system, the method of the cosmic law of attraction and repulsion, which governs our atomic form, and to the question of sex, which is inherent in every kingdom of nature. They give the clue also to the constitution of the divine hermaphrodite. PHEGYCRAYANDSOLARFIRE 513. Therefore, it is necessary to bear in mind the relative importance of the permanent atom of the second aspect of the personality within the causal periphery, and to remember that the force which flows through that atom and which is reanimating the force of the astral body is following the mind with least resistance. Bearing upon the physical manifestation in a manner twice as strong as that reaching over the other two. The logos expresses himself now through the divine ray, his second aspect, and this ray is the sum total of the radiation of the Lord of Wisdom, the heavenly men, the dragons who are unity and who are love.
In number, and play upon these points or circles analogous to the electric.
on the astral permanent atom. The physical permanent atom has a position relatively close to the positive center and a force plays through it and passes it. Onto the astral permanent atom in the form of five rays of parti-colored light which blend with the intensely vivid hue of the astral permanent atom and increase its intensity until the blaze is so excessive that it appears to the onlooker as if the two points blended, or the two electrons merge, and in merging produce such an intensity of light that they are seen as dissolving. The mental unit, having a position within the causal body analogous to the planet furthermost from the sun, becomes vibrant likewise, and the two other points considered now as one begin to interact with the mental unit, and a similar process is set up and is pursued until these two points circulating around their positive center also approach each other, blend, merge, and dissolve. The center. A positive light gathers and synthesizes the three points, and thus the three fires of the personality repeat on their tiny scale the microcosmic procedure seen in the synthesis of electric fire, solar fire, and fire vibration, and only a blazing unit is left. This blazing unit, through the combined heat of its being, burns up the causal body, and escapes back onto the planes of abstraction. Thus man is the path itself, and also the pilgrim upon the path. Just as he burns, he is also the burning ground. The analogy holds true in the case of the microcosm view from monadic levels and his manifestation as monad, ego and personality, and thus the process is carried on as it concerns a heavenly man, and likewise a solar logos. Should the brain suffice to hold the concept, thus, THEGOYCRAYANESOLARFIRE 515. Is the process also on cosmic levels for such high existences as the seven rishis of the Great Bear, and that still greater being, the one about whom non-MAYBESAID? 3. The cerulean, the evil gray. We'll take up now the subject of the cerulean in the permanent atom, and see in what manner they are affected by the egoic ray, remembering always that we are considering them as, first, the interior economy of the life germ on the three planes which concern man in the three worlds, second, as the seventh principle in each of the three sheets, and third, positive nucleus of force which holds together the matter of the three sheets. Let us therefore study two things. The composition of the permanent atom. The difference between the mental unit and the astral and physical permanent atom. To do this with clarity, and so bring some kind of definite concept into being from the dark regions of abstraction, let us tabulate. A. The composition of the permanent atom. The permanent atom of the astral and physical planes is a sphere of physical or astral substance, composed of atomic matter, and characterized by the following qualities: responsiveness. This is its inherent power to respond to the vibration of someone of the heavenly. Men, as it is transmitted via the Deva, or Brahma aspect, of his threefold nature. The permanent atom finds its place within the sphere of influence of one or other of the great Devas who are the Raja Lords of a plane. Form-building power. These Devas sound forth two syllables of the threefold microcosmic word and are each on their own plane with their inherent agency which gathers. 516 ATRE ATISCONTOSMICFIRE. must ever be borne in mind that man is essentially, as regards the physical plane, an etheric being, and his semi physical body is esoterically regarded as below the threshold, and is not considered a principle. Relative permanency. In the seventh principle of all manifesting entities is stored up and developed capacity, acquired ability, and the atomic memory, or in other words the heredity of the thinker, viewing him from the physical standpoint or from the emotional. There is no permanence whatever in the sheets. They are built into temporary form, and dissolve when the thinker has exhausted their possibilities. The seventh principle of each sheath gathers to itself the achieved qualities and stores them up under the law of karma to work out again and to demonstrate as the plane enters in each fresh cycle of manifestation. This permanency is itself likewise only a relative one, and is the inner fire within the atomized brightly, as the external fires of the ego or solar fire beat upon it with ever increasing intensity, the atom in due time is consumed, and the inner blaze becomes so great that it destroys its encompassing wall. Peace. Herein lies the distinction between the permanent atoms on all planes, and the atomic matter of which they form a part. It is not easy to make this distinction clear. There is a desirable at this time, the mere fact is the case of one of the guarded secrets of initiation, but the distinction between the permanent atom and atomic matter may be somewhat comprehended if we state THEGOYCRAYENDSOLARFIRE 517. Permanent atom is one that has been appropriated by one of the minds that form the centers in the body of a solar lord, whilst atomic matter per se goes to the formation of other parts of this great body of light. A permanent atom is one which has come under the attractive power of the second aspect, whilst atomic matter itself is the chalice by the light of the third aspect. Out of the control of his evil lord and coming under the control of positive light. This concerns the evolution of consciousness and substance. A permanent atom comes under the direct control of the lower of the three groups of physical lords, and is the agency through which they work in the imposition of karma upon the particular entities who may be utilizing it. They work directly with the permanent atoms of men, and produce results through the agency of form until they have exhausted the vibratory capacity of any particular atom. When this is the case, the atom passes into the stage of obscuration, as is the seventh principle of any sheet. It comes under the influence of the first aspect, manifesting as the destroyer. Remember that in these affirmations we are concerning ourselves with the microcosm, and with the permanent atoms which are related to him, as regards the solar nodes manifesting in the system line here in certain with the one permanent atom, and this is his physically permanent atom. It is thus true that within the permanent physical atom of the solar node lies the ability to respond consciously to the vibration of all the planes, lies his secret of the karmic purpose of his incarna. 518 ATREHISTOSOMICFIRE. The difference between them. connection with the heavenly men, we have a secondary manifestation, and on the Buddhic plane we have their third aspect bound, looking for their paramount manifestation of force. Cosmic gaseous plane, or the manasic plane, they are essentially the divine thinkers, the manasaputras. In connection, therefore, with the microcosm, viewing him as part of a center in the body of a heavenly man, we have a lesser descent and the gaseous of higher manifestation of solarity. This concerns the three higher subplanes of what might be considered as the manifestation of man's three higher aspects in mental matter, whilst on the fourth subplane we have the mental centers of man within the periphery of his mental body, of which the mental unit is the unifying factor. This is, as has been earlier said, a deep mystery, and one that can be no further amplified. Flames and fiery energy, it seems desirable. THEGUICERANDSOLARFIRE 519. That we should here discuss the analogies on each plane, 69 with the 7th plane, reminding the student that we are speaking of the plane in the field of evolution of a solar logos, and not only is it field for the development of man. In the solar system we have the first of the three higher planes, which have been rightly called the planes of the three aspects. Second, the 7th logos principle is on the first plane, and we can consider it as the impulse in visionary matter which produced his body of objectivity. On the second plane are found the 7 heavenly men, who are his principal centers of force. There are others, but we are not here concerned with them. These latter have achieved a certain specific goal, and are thus 691. The 7 systemic planes are 1. Divine plane, 2. Monadic plane, 3. Spiritual plane, 4. Intuitional plane, 5. Mental plane, 6. Astral plane, 7. Physical, logo first cosmic ether, ego, monad second cosmic ether, third cosmic ether, fourth cosmic ether, gaseous plane, physical plane, are A. Plane of divine light, B. Plane of monadic light, C. Plane of atma, D. Plane of buddy, intuition, E. Plane of mind, F. Plane of reliance, G. Plane of physical, 3. Planes of logoic evolution, planes of sun's evolution, planes of monadic evolution, planes of human evolution, father sees fire, sun, holy ghost, central air, thought, akasha, ether, fire, astral light, ether, thought forms make realization, microcosm, the 7 planes, the 6 planes, the 5 planes, the 3 worlds, macrocosm. 7 is the number of the totality of manifestation. 3 is the number of consciousness. 1 is the number of life or spirit. 4, electric fire, father, spirit, solar fire, sun, consciousness, fire by friction, holy ghost, matter. 528 TRE ATISE on high and fire. Embodiment of centers which are now quiescent or out of manifestation. Having turned his attention elsewhere. Under another
Demonstration on manifest.